Hi, in this video, I'll be talking about the Selective Estrogen Receptor Degraders, or SERDs. What are they? Who should get them? How do they work? And what might you expect while you are on treatment? Estrogen receptors, or progesterone receptors, on tumors make them hormone receptor positive. So if the tumor that is in your body or in the body of somebody you're watching this for, if the tumor has hormone receptors on it, in particular, the estrogen receptor, these drugs might be used in that case. In particular, these drugs affect the estrogen receptor similar to how the selective estrogen receptor modulators like tamoxifen do, but they actually degrade the entire receptor. So the selective estrogen receptor modulators, or SERMs, bind to the estrogen receptor, and that keeps your body's own estrogen from getting to the tumor cell to help those cells proliferate. The SERDs work in a different way. They actually degrade the receptor of the estrogen receptor. They degrade it on the cells themselves. These drugs are not used in people whose tumors are hormone receptor negative. These drugs are given by injection, which is why we don't use them in place of tamoxifen. They're required to be given every month, and the convenience level and the fact that these haven't been shown to be superior to tamoxifen in the curative setting is why we're not using these drugs, again, in place of tamoxifen. But they are used in people with advanced disease, in people whose tumors are hormone receptor positive and the cancers in other places in the body. The SERDs will work as first line monotherapy, not combined with anything else, or in people whose cancer has progressed on another endocrine therapy like tamoxifen or the aromatase inhibitors. And they can also be used in combination with the CDK4/6 inhibitors. You'll want to check out our other video on those medications. The most exciting advance, though, is that they can be used alone in people who haven't had endocrine therapy for advanced cancer, which decreases some of the side effects of endocrine therapy and anti-cancer therapy in people with advanced disease. So in summary, the SERDs are used alone in advanced disease in people who haven't had endocrine therapy for advanced breast cancer, or they can be combined with the CDK4/6 inhibitors in people whose cancer is progressing on other endocrine therapy. The SERDs are not chemotherapy. In general, with advanced disease, we try to hold off on chemotherapy until endocrine therapies are no longer working. What are the side effects? Well, they don't lower estrogen in your body, but they do degrade the estrogen receptors. So we have estrogen in our body, and by degrading these receptors, they're going to be some of the same effects we see with the other endocrine therapies. There's also some discomfort or even pain at the injection site. This may vary according to the person who gives you the medication. So you may find that the injection does not hurt when it's given by one person, and it does hurt when it's given by another. Not to say that that is not a good clinician who gave you the one that hurt, but there are just some people who are more skilled at giving these injections. I just want to be honest with you. It's also a large volume of fluid, so we tend to give this as two separate injections, and they go into the buttocks. Again, it's given once a month, so it's not a daily injection, but that can be a troublesome effect of the medication. The other side effects are hot flashes and night sweats, just like we see with the other endocrine therapies, vaginal dryness, just like we see with the other therapies. Some people can feel fatigued, lowering estrogen in our body, and the way estrogen interacts with the tissues in our body can affect our energy levels, and sleep disruption is one cause of fatigue. And then rarely we see abnormalities of the liver function tests. the blood tests that are done before you get treated, or that are followed every 6 months or every 3 months or so. So sometimes those blood tests can be abnormal because of the medication. There is no real evidence of liver damage. It's just that the tests indicate some irritation, if you will. So I've covered what these drugs are, how they're given, how they work, some of the side effects, and the people for whom they are indicated. I hope this has been helpful. If it has, click like, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can follow us on Instagram, of course, and as always, drop a comment or a question below. While we can't give medical advice, we can certainly answer general questions. And if you're on this medication, tell the rest of the Yerbba community what it's been like for you. Thanks for watching.